ways with no heart,
ways of the world, ways of the war,
ways of the cold,
ways
cold
with
world,
no heart, ways of the world, ways of the war,
ways of the cold,
ways with no heart.
Looking for kill all kind of remedies, knowledge of self, and pay attention how you walk is survival of self. And what we're spoken to is just the works and bring forth wealth. To put it short, don't talk shit that you can handle yourself. Cold world, that is ground fair with a lot of cool cats, and you'll be missing a lot of those who felt short to react. Take heed, absorb instruction like when thirst off is right. No, I lead and not to follow, it's safe for the night. Use my little man, I love you more than I can stand. So even if I'm wrong, you never take your death for granted. Lands, work until it hurt 50 grand. Humble at accurate with flows of an acrobat created for the all to relate. All we in the same chain of this game. Tight leg, vision that picture it in frame. Let it rain, let it rain. Here today, be here for tomorrow. Granted like words of scripture for you to follow. My man, here today, be here for tomorrow. Granted like words of scripture for you to follow. My bruh, here today, be here for tomorrow. Granted like words of scripture for you to follow. My C, here today, be here for tomorrow. Here today, be here for tomorrow. Tomorrow. Here today, be here for 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 tomorrow. Tomorrow. Here today, be here for tomorrow. Here today, be here for tomorrow.
Ways of the world, ways of the war, ways of the cold, ways with no heart.
Trouble in a world filled with sorrow.
Trouble in a world, ways with no heart.
Ways of the world, ways of the war, ways of the cold, ways with no heart. Ways of the world, ways of the war, ways of the cold, ways with the heart.
Ways of the world, ways of the war,
ways of the cold, ways with no heart.
Ways of the world, ways of the war,
ways of the cold.
Songs that remind me of New York City. Must have been a summertime in New York City. To say, live your life, live your life. That definitely was a New York summer right there, man. I remember that song, man. Wow. Mama used to say, take your time, young man. Mama used to say, what was the name of that cat? Junior, the great Junior. Mama used to say, 404-382-0338. You can also email me at Doug at the Doug Stewart Show.com.
Last little notes on the NBA from last night. Atlanta Hawks get two wins in a row, man, beating the Philadelphia 76ers 99-92. The Milwaukee Bucks, after the Celtics went up on the Cleveland Cavaliers a half a game in the playoffs in the East, the Bucks get a big win against the Celtics. Yeah. Take a look at these standings. The Milwaukee Bucks right now, they're tied with the Hawks for fifth place in the Eastern Conference. I think right now the Hawks have a slight advantage percentage-wise or whatever. But they're both, no, they're exact dead heat lock, 39-36 as far as record, nine games back. So with Boston losing last night, they technically get the percentage advantage over or under. The Cavaliers get the percentage advantage over the Boston Celtics right now. So Cavs back in first place, Boston in second place, and Atlanta once again in Milwaukee, who has been playing pretty good this year. The Bucks are 7-3 in their last 10 games, playing good. They got the Greek freak, Jason Kidd, doing a tremendous job in coaching his first couple of years. Also last night, you had the New York Knicks going down to the Miami Heat. Oh, boy. Oh, boy. Oh, tough, tough New York Knicks fans. And you also had the Pelicans, who don't look now, man, but the Pelicans, DeMarcus Cousins, and Anthony Davis have been playing good. 121-118 over the Mavericks at home down there in the Big Easy. The Pelicans are 7-3 in their last 10 games. Shouts out to the Pelicans. Maybe they got something to build upon for next year. It's a wrap for this year. They ain't doing shit this year. Right now, they're in the 10th spot. And it doesn't look like they can come back. Now, they're five games out of the A spot, so they're not going to make the playoffs this year. But they are 7-3 in their last 10 games. So they've been kind of meshing, being the spoiler as far as the Western Conference. So DeMarcus Cousins and Anthony Davis, Kentucky teammates, maybe they got something cooking for the next season, 2017-18. Quick little NFL news and notes, man. The Seattle Seahawks have fielded trade offers for Richard Sherman, but they're saying that they're probably not going to move the Pro Bowl cornerback, according to Pete Carroll. Here's a quote. I don't see anything happening at all, and I don't see anything happening with any other players, just the banter that's out there right now, but it has been talked about. He's a great player and can impact another team. I can see why people would be interested in him. That's from Pete Carroll. In 2 days at the owners' meetings, the Seahawks have made it clear that they are willing to listen to offers for Sherman. Sherman had two sideline blow-ups last season that were directed at coaches. The first involved defensive coordinator Chris Richard after the defense gave up a big play in Week 6 against the Falcons. In Week 15, when the Seahawks attempted a pass play from the Los Angeles Rams' one-yard line, Sherman went off on Pete Carroll and offensive coordinator Daryl Bevel. Afterwards, Sherman did not back down, referencing the team's Super Bowl loss, and Russell Wilson was intercepted in a similar situation. Oh, I 100% support him in that. Yeah. You got a right to be mad. You got a right to be hostile. Let's see. In Week 15, when the Seahawks attempted a pass play from the Los Angeles Rams 1 yard line, Sherman went off on Carroll and offensive coordinator Daryl Bevel. And once again, reference what happened in the Super Bowl. Here's another quote. Richard went through a lot last year, most of it self-inflicted, Carroll said. He got out there and he was in the midst of a season that was really challenging for him. If you remember when he did have this issue, it was right in the midst of playing some great players week after week after week. He was teed up for it and jacked up and all that, and he was competing like crazy. He was a fantastic battler. He has 2 years remaining on his contract. He's due $11.431 million guaranteed in 17 and $11 million in 2018. He's never missed a game in his NFL career, in his six-year NFL career. He's only been in the league 6 years? Damn, he seems like he's been in the league longer than that. And he's made it to the Pro Bowl 4 seasons in a row. You go ahead and trade Richard Sherman if you want. You'd be just like the Carolina Panthers when they traded the defensive back, what's his face, that went to the Redskins. You need a lockdown corner, man, especially in this day and age of these high falutin passing offenses that they got, man. Go ahead and trade Richard Sherman. He's only been in the league 6 years. I didn't realize he was that long, young. But, you know, he played, I think he played all 4 years when he was at Stanford. So in relative terms to guys that come in highly touted, he's like a year younger than or older than you would normally see from a guy that that forfeits his last year of eligibility or whatever that comes out early. And also, lastly, speaking about the Seattle Seahawks, Marshawn Lynch is on the radar, maybe coming back to play football. Yeah. Yeah. Seattle Seahawks coach Pete Carroll once again says he talked to Marshawn Lynch about 10 days ago and that the running back is considering a return to the NFL. Now here's a quote. He came through the office and had a good visit, Carroll said on Wednesday. Lynch officially went on the reserve retire list in May 2016. If he filed for and was granted reinstatement, he would be under contract with the Seahawks for 2 more years. I knew that. Remember we talked about like a week ago, there was a story that Marshawn Lynch wanted to come out of retirement and play for the Oakland Raiders. And I was saying that, isn't he still under contract under the Seattle Seahawks? And such is the case. If he filed for and got reinstated, once again, he'd have 2 more years under his deal with the Seattle Seahawks. For John Lynch or for Lynch to play for the Raiders, the Seahawks would have to release or trade him. Lynch would be due a salary cap hit of $9 million in 2017, and he would be in line for a base salary of $7 million in the 2018 season, along with $3 million in roster bonus. He's getting a little bit old, and I think his last year he was only averaging like 3.5, 3.6 or something like that yards a carry. So he's probably lost a step. Clearly, you missed a whole year of football, and you come back and try to go out there and play, you definitely run the risk of pulling something, hamstring, groin, quad, I don't know, something. So that's a very risky proposition if you ask me. 404-382-0338. You can also email me at Doug at thedougstewartshow.com. Let me read some of your messages in the chat room on Spreaker.com. The 47th problem in the chat room says, this song reminds me of the crush I had on a little girl in middle school. It also brings up the same butterflies I had even 30 years later. Weird. Music does that, bro. Music does that, man. Whenever I hear Doves Cry, like I remember Doves Cry, man. I had that on a cassette tape, and I played it over and over and over and over and over again. And I was in love, man, with this little chick back in our middle school growing up. Like, I was in love with this chick. I'm not going to say her name, but I was in love with this chick from kindergarten on through high school. And when Doves Cry was out, man, she was giving the brother a little bit of attention, you know, finally after 15 years. And, man, Doves Cry was just like on my playlist over and over and over again. Music does do that, man. I'm telling you. I feel you, 47. From Robert Window Boy Slade, yeah, boy, Goku Daddy was their general of the army. I don't know what they're talking about. From Grego X Squad, maybe Beast Mode wants to give the Oakland Raiders a show before they leave his hometown. I guess that's the thinking. He's from Oakland, you know, big supporter of all things Oakland, and you know, playing for the Raiders probably is his lifetime dream or whatever. So yeah, I get it. From Send No More Data, we should be friends, Doug, his crush. Denise Milk and Cookies, well, damn, that's a long-ass crush, Doug. Yeah. So, Let me do a quick little research here.